I can get. Is this in range? It is. Nope. Okay. Yes.
That's first blood.
The last hit and the cut. Oh wait, the bottle. Oh my God, the timing on that is unbelievable. Meanwhile, top lane, Blade Fury dealing a lot of damage to Universe. He has no Timber Chain, so the diver's going to continue, and the right click goes the way of Dad.
Aggressive and tries for something ridiculous. Universe is usually very safe, but...
Mid lane Frostbite, that should be enough, and it is. Zeus getting the last hit. Because Arteezy's basically solo at the bot lane. But either way, Dragonaut's going to be happy with this. Oh, Universe, Timber Chaining away. I don't know if this is enough. There's the Omni Slash, and the last one takes him out to get in. So they want to get something out of this. Zai has a regener, and this is the scariest rune ever to get on Storm Spirit. He's going to try to dive this. Could secure the kill. Going to get Blade Fury, so the regen's going to run out. But he still has the zip. And Ake in a lot of trouble. In all likelihood, will be the first kill going the way of EG. So they get something out of all the rotation. It's just not very often you see Spear get underleveled. Ape Mother gets initiated on half HP just like that. And the Han used, they can't quite take him out. Ake, a beautiful TP, doesn't have Grave. Doesn't really matter at this point, though. Okay, Ape Mother better be careful. He gets the burst damage off. Arteezy goes down, but he's going to trade his life for that. Zai, in the meantime, along with the Universe, going to take out the Dazzle, and Misery, the last remaining member for Alliance in this mid lane. But he will scare them away because that tier 1 tower apparently is very, very scary. Zai, wow. He has no mana, he has Tread Switch perhaps, doesn't look to do so. Going to take, oh, the wand at the last thing, I believe it was like one charge. But here comes Juggernaut, Loda, able to take him out.
I mean, it hits all the heroes, right? So...
It does! Oh, bottom lane really initiation does. On Admiral Bulldog. Zai is completely out of mana, but that might not matter. Crystal Maiden's gonna pop her ult, but so far Lone Druid's the only casualty as EG is now on the run. Zai, like I said, no mana whatsoever. Ape Mother's gonna be able to take him out very easily. PPD in the meantime. These are really, I mean, I talked to Fear after that one Juggernaut performance, which was really good. It's just the set didn't match the performance whatsoever. Arteezy trying to go away, but the Omni Slash is gonna find him. Ape Mother takes the kill with
big deal. Good item pickup, good usage.
Arteezy gets Omni Slash, and there's his result again. So
obvious lead.
We have, I believe this is our first smoke of the game. They're gonna find our double point.
Arteezy is so dumb.
Wow. Okay.
Good mid lane, Zai. We'll be jumping away. Lotus trying to catch up to them. He might get them here because of smoke.
He gets a crit. There's the ult. It's going to be for PPD, however. And the Zeus ult, not quite enough. And there you see it again. They don't even need vision because of that beautiful Thunderbolt. You just click it on the ground. Zai is dead. Literally nothing you can... They're going to take basically no physical damage whatsoever, along with the healing ward, which Zai uses basically half his mana to take out. And this tower, one way or another, is going to go down. Oh my god, the army size solos Universe! Arteezy. Top lane zipping Ake. He has a grave if he chooses to use it. Ape Mother is here with the burst damage, but Dazzle will go down before using anything. Arteezy uses Haunt as well. And Ape Mother, the Aegis, does get activated. And actually a buyback, I believe. Yeah, Dazzle's gonna TP in. Can get a grave off if he really needs to get it. Loda, can't find PPD. We have a Global Science coming out. Zai TPing out, he'll be okay. And actually, everybody's okay. That ends up being a wasted buyback in the end for Ake.
Let's try next lane.
Free barracks, left, right, and center. Let's do it!
EG will lift
at half HP. Absolutely. Global Science on for 50 seconds. I don't know what they can do.
Jump Zai onto Ake and burst him down. Here we go.
Zai, here we go. Ake, like you said, can he get the grave up? The pipe is there to dissipate a ton of the damage. And the Omni Slash again, this time destroying poor Zai on the Storm Spirit. Zeus is gonna grab his ult, use his ult, I should say, PPD on the run. The Blade Fury at this point in the game not doing that much damage. In fact, he's gonna continue to go for the kill and gets the critical strike. He buys back into the game. Aye. Haunt is up though. Global Science again down for 24 seconds, so this might still be a free rack going the way of Alliance. Gonna Blade Fury off that. Last word. Love the auto attacks between Blade Furies. You gotta love it. Range Rax is down. Universe. My god, they get melted so easily. PPD in the meantime. Frostbit. Is this gonna be a dieback? They're just focusing on the Rax as they should be. In fact, Mjolnir basically kills them on its own. And GG's come out. Alliance dominating game one.
Yeah, talk about comfort zone. They got some heroes that they really like playing. Lone Druid.
That was supposed to be when you weren't talking right there. When you used Global.
Dominating performance, and then no one says anything. Oh, Fear.
That's the new Kappa, guys.
But yeah, I feel like this was just a strategic loss. I think Alliance got some really good picks. They put their lanes the right way. They used the weaknesses of EG's draft very well. In addition to that, they had really great